Hi, I'm Dr. David Hill, and today we're going to talk about how to treat a urinary tract infection, or UTI for short, in a pediatric patient. Now, what you do depends a lot on who the patient is, how old they are, whether they're a boy or a girl, and what the nature of the urinary tract infection is. So the big distinction we want to make is whether we think the kidneys are infected or just the bladder. What things worry us about a kidney infection? Well, any child who has a urinary tract infection with a fever probably has a kidney infection as well. We need to treat those very aggressively, usually with injected antibiotics instead of antibiotics that the child takes by mouth for at least the first 2 or 3 days of the infection. Likewise, when that happens, we want to do some follow-up studies to make sure that the kidneys, the bladder, and the ureters that connect the kidneys to the bladder are all normal. Those studies usually consist of an ultrasound of the kidneys, which shows us the size and shape of the kidneys, and then something called a voiding cystourethrogram, or VCUG for short, where we shoot a little dye up in the bladder and make sure that it doesn't reflux back up the ureters into the kidneys. In children where this happens, that can be a risk for recurrent urinary tract infections. And if these are kidney infections, the kidneys can become damaged over time with scarring, ultimately leading to kidney failure, dialysis, or kidney transplant. All of those obviously things you really don't want. Who else might have a kidney infection? Well, any infant who has a urinary tract infection, any pre-potty trained child, is at very high risk for kidney infection. And we usually always, in addition to treating those children aggressively, we do those same evaluations, the ultrasound and the voiding cystourethrogram. Likewise, it's really never normal for a boy to have a urinary tract infection. It just doesn't happen under normal circumstances, so we always get worried about anatomical issues with boys. So a boy who gets a urinary tract infection is also going to need to get a renal ultrasound, a kidney ultrasound, and a voiding cystourethrogram. Now, if those things all come back normal, then perhaps he's fine. It may be okay, but you never want to let those infections pass without really investigating why they happened in the first place. Well, what about a run-of-the-mill old urinary tract infection? Say it's a 5 or 7 or 8-year-old girl. She's potty trained. She just got some stinging when she pees, but no fever, no vomiting, back pain, nausea, nothing to suggest the kidneys are infected. Well, the treatments are usually antibiotics, tend to be a relatively short course, 5 to 7 days, but you want to be aware of some other risk factors. For example, constipation. Constipation is a frequent risk factor for urinary tract infection. So if you find out, especially that your daughter has urinary tract infections, ask her, is she pooping okay? It's an embarrassing question to ask and answer, but it may be really important because if she has constipation, she's likely to get another infection. You can also ask your child if he or she is holding their urine in when they're playing. Do they wait to the last possible moment? Do they go to a school where they're not allowed to go to the bathroom except once a day? All those things may be risk factors, and you need to address them if they're coming up. You always want to work with your doctor in treating urinary tract infections because the stakes are very, very high. You need to get the right treatment, and it needs to be done in a timely fashion. So, talking about treating urinary tract infections in children, I'm Dr. David Hill.